My name is Daniel Tsegai. I'm a program officer at the United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification. I'm in charge of drought and water scarcity issues. Today, I'm going to discuss about the land degradation neutrality and the links to drought. So the pivotal role of land. First of all, we have to see that land has a role to play on poverty eradication, biodiversity, and creating also some kind of incomes and jobs, resilience to natural disasters and climate change, food and water security and human security. So land degradation neutrality, what is it? It's a concept which is a state whereby the amount and the quality of land resources necessary in order for us to support the ecosystem services and functions and also enhance food security remain stable or even increase within the specified temporal and spatial scales. So it's about making sure that the losses that we do somewhere else is also compensated by gains in another place. So impacts of land degradation, when we discuss about the impacts of land degradation, we can say that drought first aggravates land degradation, but also climate change is also in return aggravating drought. But land degradation in a way reduces carbon storage, and that means also it is contributing to global warming. So by way of saying this, the most affected and vulnerable are the most developed, underdeveloped and also developing countries. So poverty, endemic hunger as we see it these days, and also this leads to famine and migrations and conflict over natural resources. So having said this about the LDN or the land degradation, I would also like to discuss the UNCCD drought initiative. It's also another flagship activity of the UNCCD where we have worked on this for the last 2 years. It has three pillars. First of all, we are trying to support countries to develop national drought plans based on the principles of risk reduction to be prepared before drought strikes. The other thing is we are also trying to help countries in order to learn from each other, facilitating regional efforts, facilitating also exchange of learning and practice from within the among the countries. And the other thing is also we developed a toolbox that was launched at COP14 in September 2019 in India, where it talks about the resilience of people and ecosystems, and it also provides some kind of context and local specific solutions to countries. So, and at the UNCCD, what we are aiming at is to minimize the risk. As you can see it in the map, there is a hazard map, a global map, where places like Australia and the US are dark red, which means they have a lot of drought. But when it comes to the risk map that you see it on the right side, they are in dark blue. What does it mean? It means they have less risk of being impacted by drought. So what we are aiming at is in order to reduce vulnerability, to reduce exposure to drought, so that there is less damage caused by drought. So at the UNCCD, we are aiming of working on along the three pillars. First of all, to help countries to develop an early warning and monitoring systems, to establish some kind of good capacity in terms of prediction and forecasting, trying to also disseminate this information as early as possible to the local users and beneficiaries, including farmers. And also to help countries to do some vulnerability mapping. Who is going to be affected and why? Well ahead of time, before drought strikes. And also to help countries to come up with appropriate drought risk mitigation measures. Context specific, as I said, it's also what we also show in the drought toolbox. So the whole aim is about closing the cycle of drought management. The business as usual approach is to act after drought strikes. As you can see, the reactive approach is the dark red side of the cycle, where countries try to do some kind of relief and emergency activities, uncoordinated, and it's also in many cases very expensive to also assess the impact, and then they do recover and restore, and then that's where the story ends. So what we are trying to do is we need to close the gap to work on drought in non-drought times by enhancing their early warning and monitoring systems, by making sure that they know who is going to be vulnerable, where, and the population and the regions. Also trying to identify what are their most context-specific and reality-specific drought risk mitigation measures available at hand. So this is a UNCCD drought toolbox, and you can see it on the website that I am, that you can see it on the screen. You can look into it. It's a rich material that we have tried to develop from many organizations and country parties, trying to also showcase the kind of evidence that they have. And this is a kind of a one-stop shop. So I discussed about the LDN, that's one flagship activity in the drought. So the nexus between land degradation and the drought is very important for us. And recently we were trying to do about drought smart land management approach, where we are aiming at land-based interventions in order to mitigate impacts of drought. That's what we also, from our side, what we call is nature-based solutions. So what is it? It's drought smart land management intervention is the effort to improve the capacity of soil, for example, to accept, retain, and also release and transmit water, and also increase the plant water use efficiency. And this you can also be done in a more broader sense to increase the water supply where it is needed in terms of the living organisms, or by also reducing water demand. So by first of all, there are two variables. One is the water supply, enhancing the water supply, but also trying to reduce water consumption. So this is the concept of the water, the land drought nexus, where there are interactions between water inputs and also drought, climate change, and human dimensions when they interact, and what we do in terms of water use and trying to also enhance water supply. That bosses water security. So in the end, anything which reduces the water holding capacity of the soil, anything which consumes also more soil moisture, contributes to water scarcity. So there are strong links between drought and land, and the drought land nexus is being now unpacked, and we are trying to also see the potential of making sure that we enhance this drought land nexus. Thank you.